Philippine authorities are investigating the deaths of high-profile inmates at the new Bilibid Prison who were reported to have died due to COVID-19. ABS-CBN correspondent Bianca Dava tells us why. Bianca?
Denise, the Bureau of Corrections is helping the National Bureau of Investigation probe the deaths of high-profile inmates at the new Bilibid Prison in mid-2020. Convicts were early reported to be victims of COVID-19. BuCor Acting Director General Gogoyo Katapang Jr. confirmed receiving information that a convicted drug dealer who reportedly died of cardiopulmonary arrest due to COVID-19 in June 2020 was killed inside Site Carry, an isolation area at the NBP where COVID-positive inmates are brought. On Tuesday, an inmate was fetched from the NBP by agents of the NBI to get his statements related to their investigation into the deaths of high-profile inmates in Bilibid. Apart from the said convicted drug dealer Eugene Chua, some of the high-profile PDLs who died supposedly due to COVID-19 in 2020 were JB Sebastian, Francis Goh, Willie Yang, Benjamin Marcelo, Zhang Zuli, Jimmy Kinsing Hung, Ryan Ong, and Amin Boratong. Katapang explained PDLs and BuCor personnel found the courage to disclose what they knew and what they experienced during the previous administration after suspended BuCor Director General Gerald Bantag was implicated in the deaths of journalist Percy Lapid and alleged middleman June Villamor. The acting BuCor chief said they are also investigating reports of alleged abuses committed by former corrections officials against prison personnel and inmates. Denise?
Thanks, Bianca. The bulk of the millions of COVID jabs that have been wasted in the Philippines were procured by the private sector and local government units. That's according to Acting Health Chief Maria Rosario Vergere. In a Senate hearing Wednesday, Vergere says over 44% of the 44 million wasted vaccines were bought by the private sector. Some 33% were from the LGUs, while only nearly 3% came from the national government. Vergere notes demand for vaccination has declined tremendously. Meanwhile, Vergere and former Health Chief Francisco Duque III denied preventing state auditors from scrutinizing the government's vaccine deals due to non-disclosure agreements with suppliers. Duque insisted. He even wrote to the Audit Commission over a dozen times to request such an audit. Vergere notes they may give to the commission documents related to the vaccine procurement on Thursday.
A group of Philippine employers is calling on President Marcos to defer the increase in contributions for the Social Security System and PhilHealth next year. The Employers Confederation of the Philippines made that appeal, citing the challenges posed by inflation. ECO President Sergio Ortiz Luis Jr. also says many micro-businesses are still struggling to recover from the effects of the pandemic. He adds the hike in contributions will dampen investor confidence in the country.
Kumaari, naiintindihan naman natin na talagang mahirap ang panahon ngayon. Eh, kumaari, ipospon na muna. Another year will not make a difference, that much of a difference for SSS.
Yung PhilHealth, anong gagawin sa PhilHealth? Huwag na muna magtaas.
Ewan ko. Hanggang hindi na rin resolve yung mga issues doon, sayang lang yung sinis, binabayad mo, pati pag-increase. Wala akong nakikita rason para mag-increase doon.
A local workers group also made a similar appeal. The Trade Union Congress of the Philippines believes the government should first address inflation.
Personally, I think it's not timely. Mali ang timing because of, mataas ang ating inflation, mababa ang purchasing power ng manggagawa. Pag binawasan pa natin yan, lalong baba pa, lalong hihirap ang buhay nila. Ayusin muna ang inflation natin, pababain ang purchasing power natin, pataasin ng mga manggagawa. Sa kaya natin gawin.